We're staying in the designintent.dwg file, and I've left it in exactly the same state as it was at the end of the last video. We'd created our simple title block and placed it into the Layout tab, and we'd renamed the Layout tab ISO A3 Landscape. So our title block at the moment doesn't fit over the sheet. The sheet is too small. That's the white bit behind the title block. So we need to create a page setup that allows this to operate effectively. So we go down to the ISO A3 Landscape tab, right-click over it, and go to Page Setup Manager. Now, at the moment, we don't have any page setups applied. All we've got is the current layout tab, the ISO A3 Landscape tab. So we're going to click on New, like so. And our new page setup name, I'm going to give it the same name as the layout tab, which is ISO A3-Landscape. Now, what you might want to do here is make sure that you mention how it's going to plot when you plot with it. So you might put a dash and perhaps say that you're plotting it to PDF, for example. And I'll click on OK. Now, as soon as I do that, you'll see that we go into what looks like the plot dialog box. So I'm going to simply set up some simple settings here. So we need to make sure the printer plotter is going to a PDF. So I'm going to go for general documentation, the AutoCAD PDF general documentation. If you're using an older version of AutoCAD, you might need to go for DWG to PDF, like so. I'm going to go for AutoCAD PDF general documentation. We then need to set the paper size. This is the sheet size. This is why it's too small at the moment. So we need to go for an ISO A3, which is 420 by 297 for the landscape setting. And you can see there's the 420 by 297 in the preview. You can also alter your PDF options if you want to in later versions of AutoCAD. Now, plot area, I'm going to set that to extents so that the extents of our sheet go to the extents of our title block. And I'm going to click on Center the Plot. Make sure our plot scale is 1:1 because then we've got an A3 sheet and an A3 title block. Plot style table, I'm just going to set that to monochrome, black and white for now. And down here, we're going to go for landscape. Make sure your drawing orientation is landscape, otherwise it will look a bit weird when it tries to plot. Click on OK, and you'll see that we've got our page set up in the list. Select it, double click on it, and it will then apply that to the current layout. Now, you'll notice in the current layout that our printer limits now are going over our border. So what we need to do there is we need to extend those printer limits. So we're going to modify the page setup. So select your ISO A3 Landscape PDF and modify. And what we'll do is we'll change the paper size. So we'll go for an ISO A3 expand. So you'll notice there's an ISO A3 expand 420 by 297. If I OK that now, it'll prompt me to say, oh, you've edited the page setup. Yes, I do want to update it. And then what I'll do now is when I click on close, you'll see that the expand version allows the printer limits to go outside our title block so that we don't truncate anything when we actually plot our drawing. So we've now got a page set up, all organized and ready to go. We don't actually need layout 2 anymore. So I'm going to right click on it, delete it, OK it. We're ready now to start thinking about communicating our design intent in our drawing.